In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today, my beloved, is the second Sunday of the blessed month of Abib. And the month of Abib starts with the apostle and the service. And today, God is talking to us about two things can negatively influence our service and our life. The first thing is the question which was keeping the mind of the apostles busy: who is the greatest? Who is the greatest? And the second topic was the offenses. We will focus today on the first topic: who is the greatest? This kind of question was expected from the apostles, because at this stage they were still thinking in an earthly way. When they saw Jesus on his transfiguration, they just thought of having three tents, like making something on earth to represent this event. But this event didn't take them to eternity. And when they had the guy, the child who was demon possessed, they were unable to cast the demon. And Jesus told them, you need to fast and pray to cast out demons. And when he talked to them about his death, they felt sad, because they were impacted by the thinking of the Jewish people: he is a king and he is with us, and his death is an end to this kind of relationship. That's why it is expected from them to think who is the greatest. However, they added something nice. They said, who is the greatest in the kingdom of heaven? But I can tell you, if you look to our father, the apostles, each one had something to let him feel I'm better. If I look to St. Peter and ask him, do you feel you are great? He will say, I'm the one announced the faith. I'm the one said, you are Jesus, Son of God. What do you think? If I go to John the Beloved, I ask them, do you feel great, John? He will tell me, do you know what? I am called the Beloved. I'm the one close to the Lord. I'm the one, everybody knows that he loves me. I'm special. If I look, I go to Thomas. How about you, Thomas? We always focus on Thomas and his doubt. But Thomas had another very strong situation when Jesus said he's going to raise Lazarus, and Thomas said, let us go and die with him. That's why today I will not call him Thomas the doubtful. I will call him Thomas the courageous. I'm courageous. I'm the one ready to die for the Lord. Why not me? If I take somebody like Matthew, I ask him, Matthew, do you feel great? He'll tell me, you know what? I left everything for the Lord. And he promised that anybody left anything for me will be rewarded. Do you think all what I left here, I was rich, I was authoritative, and now I left everything for him? Why not me? We are all tempted by this kind of things. I can keep going with the rest of them, but just to cut the long story short, every one of us has a talent, has a gift from God. And sometimes we think this is ours, this is our talent. And we try to make use of it for ourselves and not to feel that this is from the hand of God. That's why Jesus, if I will speak on an earthly language, he raised a red card for them. You know, when you have the red flag, the statement, the verse Jesus said with, again, is this thinking, who is the greatest, because this is a call for division, was very hard. He told them, assuredly I say to you, unless you are converted and become as a little children, you will be by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. My goodness, the apostles, they deserve to hear this? See, how beautiful the list I mentioned? And he's telling them, this doesn't count with me. I need you to convert and to be like children, little children even. He didn't say little children. Otherwise, by all means, you cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. And this is our mission today. I want to take you in a journey of conversions and a way to be great, a right way to be great. Okay? We need the converting of the spirit by judging ourselves, not by praising ourselves. Remember the prodigal son? He returned to himself and he judged himself. This is a conversion we need today. Conversion to God. You convert back to God through repentance. You convert to the childhood of holy life, simplicity. Yesterday we talked on the Vesper about simplicity. Because the more you are simple, the more you are close to God, because God is simple. We start to be complicated and compound by knowing the sin. But the more you are simple, the more you are close to God. So you will be simple, you will be humble, you will be forgiving, you will have pure love, have purity, all of this. You need to be converting to the reality. Avoid daydreams, avoid glorifying yourself. But meanwhile, do not convert back to your sin. In the Gospel of St. John, he said, you have been made well to the paralytic when he healed. Sin no more, lest a worse thing come upon you. And do not convert from the kingdom of heaven. In Luke 9, he said, no one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. Okay, you want to be great? This is a feeling everybody is having. I will show you the way to be great. The first lesson here is to be great in humility. See, instead of elevating yourself, I am subduing myself. If I look to the Holy Virgin Mary, and she got the Annunciation, she's being the Mother of God, what was her answer? What was her answer? Maidservant of the Lord. Maidservant. The angel is telling her, you will be the Mother of the Most High. And her response, I am the maidservant. That's why the Holy Virgin Mary is great. Great in what? In humility. Great in humility. Abraham, our great father Abraham, what he said about himself, and he is the father of the fathers. He said, I'm dust. I'm dust. You know what David said about himself? Huh? Don't feel disgusted, huh? He said, I am a dead dog. Have you ever saw a dead dog? David was a king, was a psalmist, but he was great in his humility because God chose in him the youngest among all his brothers. Even his father didn't think that this guy will be chosen to be the king. He sent him with the sheep to shepherd them and took all the tall, strong people to present them to be. See how we see greatness and how God sees greatness. He wanna the person, his heart is humbled to be great before him. Not the guy, his heart will be, oh my God, the earth is not worthy to me. Those people, they don't understand me. They don't know my talents. They don't know my skills, whatever. No, you are wrong. What St. Paul said about himself to be great in humility. He said, I am the one born out of due time. What does this mean? Born out of due time. A child can survive if he is born out of due time. I use the biblical expression because the medical expression is not good. So he's like incomplete creature, like something dying. What about Moses? Moses, he found himself son of first daughter. You want to see how great in his humility? St. Paul said, by faith Moses, when he became of age, refused to be called the son of Pharaoh's daughter, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the passing pleasures of sin. Greatness in humility. Greatness also in service. For example, again, every time I find a place to be great, I find the first one on it, the Holy Virgin Mary. Greatness in service. You are the mother of God. What you're going to do now? Go and serve Elizabeth. Go and serve Elizabeth. Some people, if you give them responsibility or promote them, we don't do this anymore. No. You don't know whom you are talking to. You have to understand. No. The Holy Virgin Mary, she knows that she is the mother of God, but she runs to serve. Moses the Black, you remember how he used to serve all the monks and take all their jars and fill it with water? And he was a saint. There was a story about a guy. They took him to ordain him as a priest. And he returned back to his village and he started to talk to them. So he wanna tell them how God is amazing. He told them, see how God is amazing. He elevated me and put you down. This is a right understanding? No. Greatness in the work or the deeds. Whoever does and teaches, he shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Also, greatness in giving. In giving. People, if they are good, they give their tithe. But greatness in giving is giving everything. And a good example for this is not the amount of giving, it's the heart of giving. And here the example will be, again, the Holy Virgin Mary, she gave herself for the salvation, to be Mother of God. And the widow with the two mites, when Jesus praised her and said she gave more than all the other people. And if we remember the church on the early century, they were all together. There is no rich and poor. Everybody is sharing everything, and all their needs was covered. Also, be great in your inner person. How do you feel inside yourself? The Holy Virgin Mary, she felt so lowly. But she felt how she elevated by the Lord. That's why she was great. Be great in purity. Every apocalypse, every Saturday, bright Saturday, we read a famous story, the story of Susanna. She loved purity, even if she knows this purity can cost her her life. Sometimes we don't abide with the same level. What about Joseph? He abided to purity to the degree it took him to jail, from being in control of his master's house to be in jail. There is another area where you can be great, great in love. And here the example is our Lord Jesus Christ. What he said in John 13, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. If you are a true Christian, you do like him. Definitely, you have people right and left causing you trouble. Your capability to forgive is your level of greatness and love. The big heart forgives to everybody. I remember I asked it one time, which heart size God wants from you? Which heart size? Your heart is this size, by the way. Physically, your heart is this size. Depends on your hand size. But God wanted your heart to be how big? Somebody told me all size. No, all size can be narrow and wide. But there is another thing, we call it God size. Because if God is dwelling in your heart, you will have your heart at the size of God. What is the size of God? Unlimited. Unlimited. That's why you can tolerate anybody. You want to be great today? Forgive to anybody who insulted you or who did something wrong against you. Forgive and forget. This is a greatness of love. Don't feel, this is my dignity. No, this is wrong. You are putting yourself down. The last thing I will say is be great in your faith. Faith is on a scale. The smallest faith was represented by mustard seed. And this faith was capable to move mountain. I will ask you, what is the size of your faith? You can move mountains? What if the size of a mustard seed can move mountain? What is the size of your faith? Definitely, if I want to have a great faith, I will take the Holy Virgin Mary. Again, 13 years old, you will be a mother. I don't know a man. The Holy Spirit will descend on you. This is an explanation. She didn't tell him, what about this old man sleeping inside? What is he going to do with me? But she had faith. This is God, what he wants. I am his servant. What do you think about the woman from Canaan when she came to the Lord, begging him to heal her daughter? This is not my word. The Lord Jesus Christ said, great is your faith. Great is your faith. I give you a menu of things you can be great, but don't be great in comparison to other humans. Don't be great at home, don't be great in your work only, don't be great in relationship, don't control people, don't feel I am the boss. No, be great in faith, be great in love, be great in giving, be great in service, be great in humility. A lot of things where you are really will make you a candidate for the kingdom of heaven. Because if you think in comparison to others, don't forget what Jesus said, by no means will enter the kingdom of heaven. So let us be great God's way, not our way. And glory be to God.